Silent flight, also known as hang gliding, isn't a familiar activity in South Dakota, but the Great Plains offer strong thermal winds, updrafts that keep a glider aloft. South Dakota also has a lot of flatland and plenty of safe landing zones for hang gliders. Devin Wagner and Perry Volden are two enthusiasts that you might see flying around the state. With some free time and a little curiosity, hang gliding became an enjoyable hobby for both of them.
I looked at an outlet for silent flight that was fairly easy to get into. And I looked at paragliding and hang gliding, and I actually started watching some videos on it, and I kind of fell in love with hang gliding. I actually went to flight instruction down in Florida at a place called Wallaby Ranch.
Okay, let's do it.
And they do full-time flight instruction. It's 7 days a week. And they actually take you tandem on gliders, where you're sitting essentially right next to each other. And a glider real similar to this one, except it's bigger. And they tow you behind an ultralight aircraft, and they tow you up to about 2,500 feet above the ground, and they let you fly the glider, and they start training you how to fly the glider. And it usually takes about 11 to 20 flights to be able to get your proficiency enough to fly solo.
Well, it's something that I had in the back of my mind. I'd always wanted to try it. And a few years back, my youngest son and I were doing a motorcycle ride out through Wisconsin, and there's a facility in Wisconsin that offers introductory flights. And I asked him if he wanted to do it, so we both headed over to that location, which is Whitewater, Wisconsin, and we did the introductory flight, and it was at that point that said, I'm going to do this. I'm doing nothing but getting older. You know, I better hurry. And I'm glad I did it. It's been very enjoyable and something that I don't see myself not doing until I physically am unable to do it.
With a truck, trailer, gravel road, and Mother Nature, Wagner and Volden tow their gliders into the air and fly for hours at a time.
Our winch is a machine which we mount the glider up on it. It has a cradle that the glider sits on, and it has a nose release, and the pilot controls the nose release. We have a driver also that runs the truck and the winch, and what the driver does is they run the winch pressure, and they also watch airspeed for you to tell you if it's safe to take off. And what we do is we accelerate down the road.
Go, go, go.
When we actually accelerate, we get up to between 28 and 35 miles an hour of airspeed, and when we actually release it from the truck, the tow line will start paying off. And as it pays off and the glider's coming away from the truck, the glider flies at a constant airspeed of about 23 miles an hour or so. And then as the truck accelerates away, the truck will go up to about 55 miles an hour on the road. And they drive about 3/4 of the way down the road, and then they slow down, increase pressure, and then it acts like a slingshot, and it'll launch the gliders up to altitude.
Wagner and Volden prefer hang gliding to powered flight. They say it's a more peaceful experience.
It's Mother Nature. I mean, there's no motor. It's you take advantage of what Mother Nature provides. In the case of windsurfing, it's the winds. In the case of hang gliding, hopefully on the right day, it's the thermal conditions that you're dealing with that'll keep you aloft for ideally hours.
It feels like you're almost like a bird. And it's very surreal. It's almost like a dream when you're up flying. It's hard to place it. At times it feels like the hand of God lifting you. And that's pretty amazing.